Have you been recently diagnosed with type 2 diabetes and your doctor prescribed you some sort of medication you know nothing about? You may seem confused and lost, even though you know that you're in good hands of your healthcare team. Well, no need to worry, because today I'll guide you through the main diabetes medications, how they work, and their possible side effects. And by the way, my name is Amy, and I'll be your personal helper in guiding you through your diabetes journey. More videos are yet to come, so hit that subscribe button on the Klinio channel. I don't want you to miss a thing. Okay, let's get back to diabetes medication now. Since you've been recently diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, you may have to take oral tablets called metformin. It's usually the first diabetes medication your doctor will prescribe if a healthy diet and physical activity are not enough to manage your blood sugar levels. Metformin reduces the amount of glucose the liver releases into the body. Now, the tablets should be taken with food to avoid any side effects like heartburn or nausea. However, if lifestyle changes together with metformin are not controlling the blood sugar well enough, your doctor might prescribe additional medicines. Okay, what are the other options? Well, people with diabetes might need to take a glucagon-like peptide-1 receptor agonist, for short, GLP-1 agonist. Okay, but what is that glucagon-like peptide-1? Well, it's a hormone that gets released into our bodies whenever we eat. So this medication mimics the action of the hormones and stimulates the body to secrete more insulin. Now, this extra insulin is going to help lower blood sugar levels. GLP-1 agonist is usually an injectable medication, but there are also tablets. However, some diabetes patients can have some side effects from GLP-1 agonists, such as nausea or diarrhea. These effects are usually mild and do not result in cutting off the drug. Okay, I know that some people are worried about the GLP-1 agonists leading to hypoglycemia, the condition when your blood sugar levels are too low. But this risk is increased only when this medication is combined with another one called sulfonylureas. However, this medication is no longer commonly prescribed. Many people with type 2 diabetes ask if they will need to take insulin. And as you may know, people with type 1 diabetes will always require insulin injections because their body produces little or no insulin. But someone with type 2 diabetes may need insulin injections as part of their treatment plan as well. You might need insulin further down the line if your body is not producing enough insulin for your specific needs. Okay, so some types of insulin work very quickly and are taken with meals, while others are long acting and are used just once or twice a day. But if you've just been diagnosed, then this is not your case at this moment, so please, you do not need to worry. Another additional medication in diabetes management is sodium glucose co-transporter 2 inhibitor, also known as SGLT2 inhibitor. Now, this is a new line of additional treatment that prevents glucose from being reabsorbed into your kidney and removes the extra glucose through the urine. It shows fewer side effects than other medications, with just a small number of patients complaining about yeast infections. Now, you need to keep in mind that extra medications in diabetes management is not the same for all people. It all depends on your diabetes and how it progresses and specific health factors, so each patient is unique. The good news is that there are more options than ever before to help you manage your diabetes. Now, check the next video on what to do if you're diagnosed with diabetes and another one about what causes type 2 diabetes. See you next time.